Trainspotting as a film is controversial, but for me it was just sort of, when I was allowed to watch it, because I was too young obviously when it came out, I was actually born the year it came out, which is horrible. I wasn't allowed to watch it until I was about 14, but my dad was more apprehensive to let me watch it because of the culture I grew up in. I come from Ontank, which is one of the most deprived areas in the whole of Kilmarnock basically, and has a lot of drug use and alcohol abuse, and seeing Trainspotting for me was like a glimpse of reality for cinema, as opposed to other Scottish films. I feel like it was more down to earth for me, although it is horrible to see, I needed to see it. My dad calls it the film that puts everybody off of drugs. And it's one that definitely stays with you forever, and I'll forever watch it. And it was controversial for the rest of the world to see, because you don't see that in media every day, no matter where you are. So for, like Chris said, for them to see it in America, it would have been really shocking, but it's what people need to see. It's the shock factor that does it for me, and it makes me feel Scottish in a strange way. The way Irvin Welsh wrote it, the dialect, the features, you know, when they're running about Edinburgh, I can say, oh, I've been there. Or when I walk about Edinburgh, I'll be like, oh, I've used that cash machine before. And it's more of a culture film for me than a novelty film.
So basically it's a more personal approach to mm-hmm. the culture rather than something, say, like the Braveheart film, which is a very yeah. idealistic...
Uh-huh. It's culture. It's the part of Scottish culture that people need to see. It's the part that people usually take and make it comical. For example, Lemmy's show with his characters, which is good because it does need to be comical, because that's our lives. You know, you get in a bus every day and there are people that are on drugs and people that have been drinking or have suffered with alcohol or drug abuse, and Trainspotting made that a reality, especially when you see the characters that die or the characters that, you know, dismiss their child because drug is their main priority, and it's a big problem in Scotland, but it's what everyone needed to see at the time. I think it did put a lot of people off of drugs, and I think they should show it in schools. Especially in my area, because you'll see people growing up and going through secondary, and then 2 weeks later, you know, well, it feels like 2 weeks later, it's 2 years later, you see them lying in the street and begging for money and asking for money for drugs, or they are out their face, and it's horrible to grow up and watch that, but because I'd seen Trainspotting, it made it a bit easier for me to handle.
So it was easier to deal with the reality
mm-hmm.
of the situation because you had seen it?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'd seen a film version yeah. of it, but they're really good at keeping it gritty.
Yeah.
And as close to reality as they can.
So would you say it was an accurate portrayal of that life?
Yeah, it's an accurate portrayal for me, especially seeing it growing up, because everybody, you know, will walk around and say, oh, there's just another junkie, and that's really bad, because it shouldn't become a word in our vocabulary that's used every day, but it is, because that's where I grew up, and that's just the... that's the norm for them around there. It's the normality.
Yeah. Any final opinions on Trainspotting? I know you feel rather passionate about it.
Just that Trainspotting for me is not my idealistic version of Scottish culture, but it shows the culture that everyone needs to see.
Mm-hmm.
It shows the side that governments hide. It shows the side that governments just brush off, and for them to do, you know, nobody's going to make a film now that goes along the same lines as Braveheart, because we're not all about freedom. Not everyone has to have that idealistic version of Braveheart and freedom. Just Trainspotting did what the government didn't, and that's why it's my ideal Scottish culture movie.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And that's it.
so I think Braveheart's an interesting film because it came out years ago, and generally I think the rest of the population think of Scottish people as people who fight for their freedom and are really patriotic, which I don't know if that is the way it comes across, but that's how I feel that people see Scottish people as. But relating that to real life, I don't think it's as true, considering if you take in the independence referendum we had a couple of years ago and we voted no, it was basically split half and half. It was like 45% of the country wanted freedom, and I think that shows that more than half don't actually care about that, don't care about having our own rights and our own freedom and making a life for ourselves on our own, which I think Braveheart really tries to push. Obviously it's part of history as well, so it's maybe changed over the years, but I think Braveheart's an interesting film because it shows in a way that we are quite self-centred as a kind of population, thinking that every Scottish person hates the English, which just isn't true, in my opinion. I think you hear a lot about it and people kind of take that as a stereotype, but like a lot of stereotypes, it isn't true to life. Braveheart was one of the films, I've only seen it once or twice, and I was quite young when I watched it, and I felt too young to see it, but at the same time, the kind of feel I got from it was that I am Scottish, I am proud to be Scottish, and this is who I am, which has followed me through life, and I was a yes voter for the referendum, and I think it's important to have that, but it's not just because I think, oh, we're Scottish, we should be, that's all that we are. I think it's more political stuff that comes into that, but the film isn't quite the same in the way that it's, we don't hate other cultures, and I don't think that that's true in our today's society.
Do you think a lot of politics had to do with how Scotland was portrayed in the film?
I don't think so as much then. I think there's a lot more kind of history elements to it, which I won't go into because I'm not very good at remembering all that. I don't know much about it. But I think it was more about the patriotism and kind of fighting for your freedom at that point. But it was a completely different world to how we are now. It was a long time ago, and I don't think that it does really stick as well. And as Erin was saying in her interview about Trainspotting, I think that's something that can follow through Scottish culture for a long time, sadly, actually, because of the drug abuse, which I think they're completely different films, but they both show different elements of Scottish culture, and I don't think that Braveheart is as true to life as Trainspotting.
Mm-hmm. Would you then say that it was idealistic a few hundred years ago then?
Yeah, definitely. I think a lot. I don't think that it's good to follow through life, because when you think of Braveheart, the first thing that you think is, oh, freedom for Scotland, blah blah blah, but when you dig deeper into it, I think it's more we're not open to change, we're not open to hear about other people, we're not open to anything else that is other than what we are right now, which I don't think in today's society where everything's all over the place, it's not how it is anymore.
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me in today.
Thank you very much for doing the interview for us.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.